up everyone, welcome to episode 10 of the Let's Play Pokemon White 2 playthrough with the Terminal Gamers. Yeah, let's go. Alright, so anyways, last time we left off with a really underleveled team. So you'll have noticed now the team has grown in levels quite a bit. Let me just show you the summaries. Okay, can't even show that way. So I'll just spell it out. So Buckbeak has reached level 27. With the moves Quick Attack, Roost, Air Cutter and Gust. Bruno has reached 27 with Takedown, Ember, Reversal and Fire Fang. Eve has reached 28 with Dig, Covet, Takedown and Bite. Monfidior has reached 27 with Leaf Tornado, Growth, Mega Drain and Leech Seed. Captain Crunch has reached number 27 with Dig, Torment, Sand Tomb and Assurance. And today's aim is to finish the gym, which is on that side, and also to save this girl from being harassed by these two people. So we are partnering up with Rosa in fighting the subway bosses. Come on. Ingo and Emmett, the subway bosses, both of them dabbing. They've got Girder and a Boldore. And I have Buckbeak up front. Oh, that's perfect. But the Boldore can always attack us. And things will get messed up real bad. Please hit the Boldore. Thank you. Now the threat posed to Girder is over. So you don't need to worry about that anymore. And Buckbeak's up to 28. Ooh, and Rock Throw. Okay, that had Rock Throw and just about missed Buckbeak. Got lucky there. Water Pulse will finish off the Girder to give us the victory. Nice. Okay, so that she's given us, I think that's the VS recorder or something. Yeah, it's the versus recorder. Come on, stop talking already. Yeah. I'm gonna quickly get on the bicycle and check out these two buildings because one of them has a really handy item. And whoa, did you just see that? The Crocroc and the boy are moving in sync. Okay, now they stopped. But that was crazy. Talk to that guy anyways. He'll give you a sunstone. Then come over to this house. Go upstairs and talk to this old lady here. She'll give you the soothe bell, which increases happiness towards a particular trainer. It would help if we gave it to Eevee. It would make it an Espeon or an Umbreon. But we don't want either. We want a Vaporeon. But it's good to give if you had a Pokemon which knew Return. But I didn't teach Return because that's boring. So come on, come here. Now here is the gym area. The gym was relocated and all that. We got an extra transceiver. So this is just another side quest in the game with Yancy. If you're if you're the boy, then this character is Yancy. And if you're a girl, I don't remember the name. So anyways, the side quest is you return it to her like very, very much later on. Anyways, you gotta beat her to battle here. And whoa, okay, the breeder's fighting us, and she's got it's nursery 8 June, but I am recording this in October, so I don't see the point of that. But this thing should go down in one shot, nevertheless, to an air cutter. So now that we've beaten that, what? Is she flirting with us? I see us wearing the so muggy. I shouldn't have worn my apron. Maybe you shouldn't be disclosing all these bodily facts about yourself. Oh god, sweat is making my clothes stick to me. I'll be fine, check out the scenery. Oh! This does not define romantic. Yeah, as if they were going to install miniature air conditioners in each little cabinet of the Ferris wheel. But anyways, wow, so apparently she likes us. Yeah, that's it. Punchline. Let's get in here and check this person. Whoa, that's cool. This is where the older gym was. This is where the gym was in black and white. And now the path has changed for this roller coaster. Let's try to board it in time. No! Just missed. Let's get Sandile out front, Captain Crunch. Because I know for sure that this place is all about the electricity type, all about the electric types. So we're just gonna get Sandile out front, and let's go ahead and teach Sandile the move Rock Tomb, which I went back to the Relic Castle and got it because there was a way to navigate it, which I didn't do. I'm gonna take out Torment and get ourselves a Rock Tomb. And the roller coaster's here just in time to take us over into possibly our first battle of this place. Okay, no. Hey, looks like there is no one in here, and we're just here to waste time and just show off the fact that this was the last gym. Okay, call me tomorrow when the roller coaster arrives. Oh gosh, right here. So we're in a battle right now, that's cool. Okay, so quickly we gotta fight this guy. Rich boy Roland. Hey, it's a good thing we got Sandile up front, cause he's the one with the amulet coin. He gonna make those rich boys give us extra rich. That should take him out in one shot, no problem. And Moxie will raise my attack. And that's it for Rich Boy Roland. Roland. R-O-L-L-I-N. Roland. Let's hop onto the roller coaster and move on. And my partner has now joined me.
Hey.
that change the path of the roller coaster and now wait for it to come. And it's here, so, and we have a battle. We have Lady Colette, another trainer class who has loads of money. And she's got a Flaffy. And the previous guy, I'm pretty sure, had a Blitzel, so I don't see the relation there. Boom! Flaffy goes down. Then attack boost. Moxie really helps out. Oh, I thought she said strong and horrible trainers for a second. Ooh, some roller coaster tricks we got going on there. And, oh man, that's stupid. Now we gotta just sit and wait for the roller coaster to arrive, which it has. And now we are going to go to the real gym. Which has now become a catwalk, which is stupid. And we're gonna get a fresh water from our dude here who's so awesome. So there's a whole bunch of trainers watching the challenger going up. Beauty Nicola with her Elekid. And it's a level 27, so we got some nice competition here. It's much better than having a level 24 Pokemon fight these things. Please tell me you don't have an Emolga. Thank you. Why would you send out a Flaffy though? Boom. Say bye, Flaffy. Oh, you live. And you use Charge. Why would you do that? You're real stupid, you know. I'm just gonna dig again. Maybe she'll switch. Oh! She tried to take down. Boom. Moxie's gonna boost my attack and just make that Elekid into mincemeat. And Captain Crunch learning Crunch. Nice. Taking out assurance to get that. Elekid's up next. Hey guys, if I show you an Elekid get melted in 1 second, you gotta subscribe. Okay, so how to melt an Elekid in 1 second? A small tutorial by the Terminal Gamers. 0, 1, there we go. Perfectly wrecked in 1 second. So that my friends, is how you wreck an Elekid in 1 second. And we won the match, and everyone in the auditorium is full clapping and everything. So then, again, we got the next battle against a little bit of a camera shift right there. So this next lady's got Flaffy. That's gonna go down easily to one shot for sure. And the Moxie boosts her attack again. That is so awesome. Captain Crunch up to level 29. And there's a Blitzel coming up next. So we're going to dig and destroy this blizzle as well. So then this blizzle will go down easily. And Sandile is evolving. That's awesome. Because we really need him to fight this gym for us. Oh yeah. It's a Crocorock. So now we've got a Crocorock. Yo, so next we gotta go up further. Let's get Eve out front actually, because he's got Dig. Buckbeak or you know what, let's get Dig on Bruno and then get him out front. And I got the TM for Snarl out at the Lost Lawn Forest. And gosh, how tough it was to skip all the trainers, except for one, the cop, who's right as at the route. I didn't battle anyone else. I have a very, very special method of training, which I figured out myself, because I'm really smart. No, I'm just kidding, I'm the stupidest guy there is. So anyways, now we got Bruno out front. Beauty Ampere. Okay, Ampere is a unit of electricity, which is a good one considering not many people know that. They all think it's Watt. Spark is not, hopefully not paralyze us. Thank you. Boom. Hopefully the blizzle goes down. There is no same type attack bonus. Oh, the blizzle goes down. That was a critical hit. Beauty Ampere uses Elekid again. Elekid. I have no idea how you say it. But after we beat the gym, there's a ton of other stuff you can do here in Mimbasa. Beauty Ampere has been defeated. And we are now liable to fight the gym leader, Elesa. And so now that we've got a fully healed team, we can go on and fight the gym leader. A bit of a shift in the camera there, but yeah, we got Captain Crunch out front, hoping to set up a Moxie sweep. Against gym leader number 4, Elesa, here we go. Starts out with an Emolga at level 28. Good thing we got our level 29 Crocorock here. Oh, I forgot to restore PP for. That's okay, he's going to be one-shotting pretty much everything. Except for Simolga here, because, yeah. Speed will fall though. So we might just go first here. Okay, no, Emolga's so fast that speed drops don't do anything to it. Because Emolga lives the thug life. And we've got Captain Crunch in a very, very horrible situation right here. Ooh, a critical hit. Nice. Is this it? Has Captain Crunch or... This Emolga keeps rock tombing. That's not fair. I don't even think I have any healing items. So I've just got to YOLO and hope for the best. Okay, I'm pretty sure we can knock out the Flaffy without getting any... What if that has quick attack? Yep, it has quick attack. Ooh, I got citrus berry. I got fresh water. Let's use it. And take down was what? Ow. Dig. So that's one dig used up. We've got two digs left. Gosh, I'm so stupid. I had no PP on dig and I just used it. Flaffy will go down easily because of the Moxie. And another Moxie boost. And Captain Crunch up at level 30. And let's make a pact that Captain Crunch's level at the end of this gym battle will be the level of my entire team at the beginning of the next episode. So say Captain Crunch finishes off, oops, say Captain Crunch finishes off at 30, everyone's gotta be 30 at the start of the next episode. But he's probably gonna be 31 considering he took down the Zepsika in just one shot there. Which is really nice. And we destroyed this gym leader. So our photograph is going to be displayed at the back. So yeah, look at that, gym battle. So we have now got 4 gym badges. What? We've got to walk with the D-Boss. Now we can move on. Woo! We've got 4 gym badges, guys. 4 to go. But that's not all. I'm just kidding. That is all. Because there is nothing to do in the music place and stuff like that. Ooh! Spoke too soon. Team Plasma. What? Okay, fine. So looks like we've got to give you support here. So you've been training your Pokemon for 2 years? Oh man, it's probably level 100. Because I'd probably get level 100 if I trained for 2 years. It's a level 27 rubbish. What rubbish? Ouch, I have 2 PP. No, I have 1 PP on dig, which just got exhausted. Boom. A critical hit there, which was really useless. And level 31. Oh boy, one more level of training. Excuse me. Hey, team plasma number 2. Looks like this one's going to be a girl. And it's a watchdog we're up against. I think we can just crunch this watchdog to high heaven. Oh, super fang. Okay, we aren't dying. Wow, that was stupid. Why would you use a super fang? Captain Crunch, now at level 31, shows that we got quite a bit of training to do now. Sad music. Thank you. So that's gonna be it for this episode, guys. Next episode, we're gonna head out east and. No, we're gonna head out west. We're gonna go west and east is this way. But east is also a cool route, but we're not going there. That's too much work. So, west is next episode. We'll see you all next time. Peace. Ah.